Hello, everybody. This is Mr. Liquid Bread with another beer review episode. Tonight, we're going to talk about a brewery. I don't know much about this brewery at all. It is a brewery here in Michigan. I've had, I think, a couple other beers previous to this. I don't think I've done any beer reviews on them yet. But this beer goes out especially to a buddy of mine, Mike Cross, who recommended this beer. And I went out tonight and bought a six-pack of it. We'll, I guess, take a little taster gander at how it tastes. But anyways, this is Shorts Brewery, The Magician, just like the Ohio State University, it's the Magician. This is a dark red London-style ale, the Eloquent. What's it saying here? Wipe the condensation off. The eloquent, swift, and skillful master who makes things happen. Very, very sly. I like that. Alrighty, what else we got here? Yeah, this is Shorts. Again, this is Shorts Brewery. They're based out of Elk Rapids, Michigan, which is way up near Traverse City, Michigan. And if you're not familiar with Michigan, in Michigan we throw the hand up. That's our map right there. Everyone's born with two maps. Boom, boom, right there. I mean, what are you going to do? So anyways, there's Michigan. It's up in this area. Traverse City's up in this little nook up here by the pinky and ring finger. That's where Elk Rapids is. Traverse City is the place where people go to hang out that are from Michigan. Madonna, Tim the Tool Time Taylor, whatever his real name is, I don't remember. Mr. I snort cocaine and drive 100 miles an hour in my Corvette. Although you've been good, Tim the Tool Time Taylor, so I'll give you a little golf clap for that real quick. Anyways, I'm getting off topic because I've had a few beers already tonight. So anyways, yeah, this is Brewed and Bottled in Shorts Brewing Company out of Elk Rapids, Michigan. And it's got a little picture there of a funky magician on the front. I wonder if that's the master brewer up there at Shorts. But first of all, I'd like to say that this beer is dark. Well, it's not that dark. I was told by my buddy that this was a dark beer. I can actually see light passing through it. There is a little bit of sediment in the bottom. Not much, just a little bit. I want to make note, Shorts does have a nice unique bottle cap, which is always prudent. I assume this is the right way up. It's basically a looks like a man's torso with a pair of hillbilly-like shorts on. Get it? Shorts. Like Shorts. Shorts Brewery. Anyways, I give props to that. Nice bottle cap. I like the white, too. That's pretty nice. Let's pop this bad boy open. He said this was a really good beer, so we'll have to take a peek at this. Got some good CO2. Man, that beer is full, pretty full there. Ooh. It's misleadingly dark smelling. I mean, right off the bat, I smell this and I smell kind of a chocolate or porter-esque type aroma coming off of it. All right, let's take a little sip here. Whoo! That's got some bite to it, baby. That is that's the London style, I think, right there. It doesn't look dark. I was told it's dark in the glass. This is a dark beer, tasting beer, definitely. This almost tastes like a porter. Very chocolatey tasting. Yet, sour undertones underneath the chocolate. Almost like an aftertaste. Immediately tastes like a dark porter type tasting beer, and then as you swallow and you get that air hitting your tongue again, it's almost just a twinge of sourness. That's probably the London style ale. I know some Scottish ales are kind of like that. They're kind of off the beaten path of the normal American ales, where they're more hoppy. It's good beer. Very good beer. Not much of a summer beer, but definitely a fall or winter beer. Definitely warm up that liver. You know, fires up that liver in the stove, gets it all nice and toasty. We got an alcohol content on here. No, it is handmade by people who care. I'm glad it's not handmade by people who don't give a shit. That would pretty suck. That'd pretty much suck. You know, pull a fingernail out of here as you're drinking it or something like that. No alcohol content on it, though. Probably was on the box. I might have the box sitting around here. Hell yeah! There's the box. The Magician, Shorts Brewing Company on it. Handmade by people who care in Northern Michigan. Versus people who... Handmade by people who care in Eastern or Western or Southern Michigan. Here's if you want to see. Life is short. You gotta get some massive reflection on that. Life is shorts. Drink it while you're here. And if you don't know what that is, that's a picture of where Elk Rapids is. There's a bunch of inlets and stuff up in Northern Michigan. And that's, looks like, if I can get this, that's where they're located. Actually, that's Bel Air, one of their breweries. Let me get the reflection off. And the other one is over here. That's Elk Rapids. That's probably right on the shores of Lake Michigan. But yeah, anyways, long story short, I don't see a damn alcohol content in here, so I can't give you an alcohol content on this. Life is shorts. But that's it. Nothing else to say about this. Very porter-esque tasting. Very, very much a sour aftertones after you get it down. Yeah, sour. A little bit of sourness to it. And I think that's that London style. They have that weird, different taste. I mean, obviously, it's a London style or British style, Scottish style type beer where the Americans like to hop the shit out of everything and everyone. So, all right. So, that's the beer. Let me take a slam. Ah! That's not a beer to slam. Ho, ho, ho! Holy mackerel. Woo! Oof, that's got some sourness to it after you get that sucker down. Man. So let's see. We got a good bottle cap. Boom, right off the bat. I like the flavors. A lot of flavor going on. We got some chocolate some overtones and some sour undertones afterwards, in the aftertaste. I'm not really into these sour beers. Apparently, they're becoming hot. When I was out in Philly, last couple years, they've had some sour beers out there at the Kennett Square Brew Fest is where I've been, and man, those beers are like sour apples, nasty. So I'm not a real big fan of the sour undertones on this. So I'm actually, unfortunately, going to give this probably about a 5. It's a mediocre. Definitely got a lot of flavor. If you like beers that have a sour taste to it, I definitely recommend it. Maybe you'll like it more than I do, but in my opinion, I'm not a real big fan of this, the sourness, the London style out of this beer. So I'm going to give it a 5 on this. So sorry, Mike Cross, it wasn't as good as, I didn't think it was as good as you hyped it up to be. Don't believe the hype, as Flavor Flav says, for all you old school rap fans out there. Anyways, so this is Mr. Liquid Bread. I know I got off kilter there a second, but hey, that's what happens when you drink beer, you know, you get a little woo. So anyways, have a good night. That's another episode. See ya.